So someone was asking me the other day whether I could automate entering shifts for employees into a work schedule. Now, this isn't exactly what he had in mind, but he gave me some ideas on doing this. So what we have is we have 10 employees working at this corporation, and they work 5 days straight and get 2 days off consecutively. And so what I've done is I've created something so that it will put in 5 days on and 2 days off for every employee. And once again, they have 10 employees, but they have they need six. So on the bottom, this is my same shift schedule that I've showed you how to create before. So this is for the month of May, and they need six people working at every day. So let's run this. The days off are indicated with an O, and conditionally formatted, so if they're O, they're green, so that they stand out a little bit. And so there you have the complete shift schedule for them. And you can see the number of people working, and all of these are over six. So when it says -2, that means that they have two people extra there. Now, so let's undo this. So let's just delete the shift schedule. And this is what I'm thinking would be an advantage to be able to run this. So let's say employee number one wanted vacation days 11th, 12th, 13th. So let's enter vacation, and I've color-coded or conditionally formatted that so it turns yellow. And so we've entered the vacation. Now let's run the, I've set up a box, a button to run my schedule here, and I'm just not going off and running it. So let's run this again. And then you see that when you run the schedule with the vacation in there, on the 11th, you have a problem. There's only going to be five, and so you're going to be short one. But on the 12th and 13th, it's going to be no problem. So maybe you could talk this person into possibly taking their vacation the 12th, 13th, and 14th, and that way you would have no problem. So let's change this to an X, and let's change this to a V. So if this person were able to change his vacation to the 12th, 13th, and 14th, this would allow your schedule to work perfectly because there's no days that you're short of anything here. So let me show you the code. So basically what I used is I used the offset function. So I figured out the first row, I equals 4 equals the fourth row is where the employee goes. And so I say range I3 and I4 is off, and then the next 5 days. So I shift it by 7, and then I put the next 2 days off, and I keep going, shifting by 7 and doing those all the way down. Now, I do a lot of copying and pasting on this little bit of code here. So I copied the whole works from I equals 4 to I equals 5, and now what I have done is I've shifted it over by 1 for the first, I've offset it by 1 for the first row, and then I've added offset to, instead of 7, 14, 21, I have 8, 15, 22, and 29 to figure out the rest of them. So I've done that for all of the 10 rows. And then what I've done is I've gone through the range from C4, which is C4 to AG13, which is C4 here to AG13. And then I have said range C4 to AG13 dot replace what, and I have what is as nothing, and if there's nothing there, replace it with an X for working. So that is how you enter a schedule for your employees automatically. I will include this VBA code in my description. please subscribe.